안녕하십니까. Hello, 대한민국 everyone. 정부의 코로나19 I'm very pleased to welcome you to the webinar on COVID-19 for policy and technology sharing. The ninth special webinar is held under the theme of Korea's policies and practices of the 21st general election amid COVID. I am Deputy Director Hae Jun Chun of Elections and Local Council Division, Ministry of Interior and Safety. Let me introduce the order of today's webinar. First of all, Vice Minister Jong In-yoon of Ministry of Interior and Safety in charge of election will deliver opening remarks to be followed by Deputy Director Hwa Young-shin from Elections and Local Council Divisions of the Ministry to talk about voting procedures for confirmed patients and self-quarantine, infection preventions, and then there will be Q&A session. Vice Minister Jong In-yoon of the Ministry will deliver opening remarks.
Good afternoon. I am Vice Minister Jong In-yoon of Interior and Safety of the Republic of Korea. It is a pleasure to meet election officials and experts in the world at today's webinar. Currently, almost all countries in the world are facing the COVID-19 outbreak, and the governments in the world are committed to protecting their citizens. Taking this opportunity, I'd like to thank all those who are committed to upholding political rights, which are important democratic value under this crisis. Ever since the WHO declared the pandemic of COVID-19, the Republic of Korea held a nationwide election for the first time in the world. Facing this unprecedented circumstance, we put our heads together to ensure a safe and fair election. The Korean government devised prevention and control measures in polling stations to block further spread of the virus, and ground rules for social distancing to ensure a safe voting environment. Also, the government made all-out efforts to guarantee the right to vote of confirmed patients and those who, under self-quarantine, who could have been left behind. Relevant agencies and institutions worked together and installed mobile polling stations that we have never carried out before, and we kept confirmed patients separate from other people and made them cast their votes in a separate voting area at different times. As a result, we were able to achieve the highest voting rate in the election in 28 years, and no new case related to the election was reported at all, which was very meaningful. This has been possible thanks to the government's active role in responding to the outbreak and our citizens who believed in the government with mature citizenship. We hope to share our policies and experience regarding Korea's general election held in the midst of the outbreak. I hope our experience in cases could help other countries hold a safe and fair election successfully. Once again, I'd like to thank all election-related officers and experts in the world for joining us today. I sincerely wish we could put an end to the global COVID-19 outbreak as soon as possible. Thank you.
Deputy Director Shin Hwa-young, Election and Local Council Division, Ministry of Interior and Safety will share Korea's policies and practices of general election amid COVID-19. First, he will address voting procedure for confirmed patients, voters under self-quarantine, and second, infections prevention and control measures, third, counting procedures and follow-up measures. Yes, Deputy Director, please start.
Good afternoon. I am Deputy Director Shin Hwa-young of Election and Local Council Division of the Ministry of Interior and Safety. Under the COVID-19 pandemic, Korea held the 21st general election seamlessly and successfully. Due to concerns over further spread of the virus, the voter turnout of the general election recorded the highest, and there was no election-related case reported at all. And let me explain the prevention and control measures we took for the 21st general election and how we implemented them. This is the table of contents. I will cover overview, existing election system, voting methods in response to COVID-19, voting methods of confirmed patients, self-quarantine voters, and general voters, counting methods, follow-up measures and conclusion. One of the goals of the prevention and control measures for the general election was to establish a safe voting environment where all citizens could cast their votes with confidence. Another goal was to ensure the right to vote of confirmed patients and voters under self-isolation in accordance with the Public Official Election Act, since they could be left behind when it comes to prevention and control measures. To achieve the goals, we allowed home voting, installed special early voting polling stations, and made confirmed patients and those who, in self-quarantine, cast their votes in a separate voting area at different times. I will explain this later in detail. First, allow me to briefly introduce Korea's election system. There are four types of voting. First is home voting, that allows you to cast your votes by mail at your home. Second, overseas voting for expatriates who reside in other countries. Third, early voting that allows voters to cast their votes 5 days before the election day for 2 days. Last is election day voting that allows voters to cast their votes on the election day. After voting is finished, counting centers in cities, counties, and districts start counting the votes. Let me explain about home voting. Home voting allows only people with disabilities or those residing in hospitals and nursing homes to vote outside of a polling station. They can vote from home after submitting an application for home voting. Home voting allows people vote by mail from home or where they reside. Next is overseas voting. Expatriates in other countries are eligible for overseas voting. Those who want to vote from abroad must apply for overseas voting in advance. Polling stations are installed in overseas diplomatic missions during the overseas voting period. Next is early voting. All voters are eligible for early voting. Early voting does not require any application or register in advance, unlike home voting or overseas voting. Early voting takes place 5 days before the election day for 2 days. Voters can cast their votes at any early voting polling stations installed in the country. Next is election day voting. All voters who do not cast their votes during the early voting period are eligible for the election day voting, and they can vote at registered polling stations. Next, I'm going to touch on counting. Counting centers are set up within the jurisdiction of city, county, and district election commission. After the voting is finished, ballot boxes are transferred to counting centers. Vote counting machines were used for ballot counting before, but the ballots were counted manually this year because the ballots for proportional representation voting were the longest ever before. Under the current election system, confirmed patients cast their votes through home voting and early voting, and those in self-isolation voted on the election day separately from other people.
Now, let me explain the concept: people who were confirmed with COVID-19 and those who were in quarantine. Confirmed COVID-19 patients mean people who tested positive for COVID-19 and are being treated at a hospital or in care center. Self-quarantine means people under a mandatory 14-day quarantine who came into contact with a COVID-19 patient or who returned from abroad. Self-quarantine are strictly prohibited from going out or making contact with others. First, let me explain the voting method for confirmed COVID-19 patients. In case of home vote, as I have explained before, the home voting registration period is set out. Between March 24th till 28th, voters can submit application for home voting. For those who had been confirmed as COVID-19 patients before March 28th will be eligible, but for those confirmed after March 28th were not eligible for home voting, then they can cast vote during the early voting period at the special voting polling station. Let me now explain home voting for COVID-19 confirmed cases. In the case of those who have tested positive during the home voting registration period, they will vote at their residence or place they reside. The ballots must be submitted by mail before deadline, which is April 15, 6 p.m. Before voting, COVID-19 patients must wear mask, disinfect hands, wear disposable gloves, and then cast vote. As a result, a total of 364 confirmed COVID-19 patients out of the total confirmed cases registered as home votes. For those who were COVID-19 confirmed cases but failed to register for home voting, special early voting polling station was set up at the care center so that they could cast vote on April 10th and 11th when early voting was held. During the voting by confirmed COVID-19 patients, polling station staffs wore level D protective gears just in case, so that they could perform their duties minimizing any contact with the confirmed patients as much as possible. A polling station was installed in a well-ventilated outdoor area. Not only confirmed patients, but also medical staff working at the care center need to vote, so different voting times was set for confirmed patients and medical staff to minimize contact. 147 confirmed COVID-19 patients and 299 medical staff used special early voting station. Next, let me explain voting method for voters in quarantine. After the regular voters finished voting and had left the premises, the quarantine voters casted vote at the temporary polling station. Quarantine persons are not allowed outside of their residence in principle, but they were allowed to go out to vote between 5:20 p.m. till 7 p.m. on election day. However, on election day, only asymptomatic, meaning no fever or coughing symptoms, quarantine people were allowed outside their residence. I'll now explain the COVID-19 precautions for voters in quarantine. First, civil servants contacted the quarantine persons via text messages or phone calls to ask their intentions to vote. When the quarantine person expressed their intention to vote, the details are informed to them, such as travel method, to polling station, voting method, wearing mask, etc. On the day of the voting, the quarantine persons are allowed to move from their residence to the polling station only. The self-quarantine safety protection app is used to track the movement of voters in real time. The quarantine person must travel on foot or by his or her own car. If they use public transportation, there could be a possibility of coronavirus spreading, so only travel by car or on foot was allowed. Temporary polling booth for quarantine was installed outdoor or well-ventilated place, and polling station staff wore individual protective gears. Upon arrival at the polling station before 6 p.m. on election day, the voters in quarantine received numbered tickets and waited to be summoned in the waiting area. After the regular voters finished voting, they cast vote according to the number on their tickets. Every time a voter finished voting, the staff at the temporary polling station sanitized the polling booth and instruments with sanitizing tissue. Only after disinfection, the next voter came in and vote. Total of 11,151 quarantined persons voted. Now, voting method for general public. General voters can cast early vote on any early voting station installed nationwide, and on the election day, they voted at polling stations in the given district where their residency is registered. In order to create a safe voting environment for voters, anti-epidemic disinfections of polling station was carried out before and after voting. And on the election day, polling station election equipment touched by voters were constantly disinfected using disinfection PC. On the election day, emergency alert text messages were sent nationwide, giving instructions to wear face mask when they come to polling station. Upon arrival, all voters undergo body temperature measurement. Voters with no temperature or symptoms can enter the polling stations. If voters with high temperature or with respiratory symptoms such as coughing were transported to temporary polling stations to cast a vote, the route to the temporary polling booth are completely separated from normal polling booth. After checking body temperature, voters disinfect their hands and wear vinyl gloves and then cast a vote. When waiting in the vicinity of the polling station, voters must keep at least 1 meter distance from others and refrain from all non-essential conversation. 1 meter distance marking guide and stickers were used on the floor or ground so that the voters could voluntarily distance themselves from each other. Next page. COVID-19 precautions were set out for the safety of polling station staff. Prevention of COVID-19 training was given to staff for voting and counting management who performed tasks only after wearing a facial mask, sanitary gloves, and face shield. In addition, we install a separate place so that they wouldn't contact with anybody. Next, counting method in response to COVID-19. First, we provided spacious counting office and assigned the proper number of persons so that the social distance is well kept while indoor air can be well ventilated. Proper distance between counting staff and counting observers was set out. Just like polling station, we checked body temperature to restrict persons showing symptoms from entering. When anyone shows symptoms, they were sent to screening clinics for COVID-19 test. We secured reserve personnel in case when counting staff could not perform their duties. As with the voting staff, the counting staff were required to wear facial mask, put on disposable vinyl gloves, and do regular hand sanitizing for disinfection. The indoor air was continuously circulated through the open window and the internal ventilation system. Let me talk about the follow-up measures to prevent the spread of COVID-19 after the election. In the case of the self-quarantine and staff responsible for voting and counting management, for 3 days after election, enhanced monitoring was done for the outbreak of COVID-19, such as fever or coughing. Staff responsible for voting and counting management, we granted official leaves or extraordinary leaves to let them have sufficient rest. List of the self-quarantine voters was shared with the KCDC, Korea Center for Disease Control and Prevention, to come up with immediate response to tracing and epidemiological investigation. Let me conclude by telling you the election result. The voters' turnout was the highest in 28 years with 66.2%. The early voting rate was the highest ever since the introduction of the system. Most importantly, after monitoring for 2 weeks, right after the election, there was not one case related to the election reported. These reasons for the achievement was not only the government aggressive quarantine measures, but also the matured civic consciousness where citizens trusted the government and followed the procedures given by the government. That concludes my presentations on the 21st National Assembly elections and its quarantine and safety measures. Thank you. Next, we'll take time to answer questions regarding the presentation. First, we'll answer questions that were received in advance in relation to the presentation today and then proceed to the answer additional questions raised during the webinar.
첫 번째 질문입니다.
What kind of policy the Korean government has implemented to encourage people to come and vote in the election? Korea's 21st general election was the first nationwide election in the world held ever since the declaration of the pandemic. And it was the first nationwide event for us too. So the government made sure there would be no single new case related to the general election. We put an emphasis on creating a safe voting environment. As I explained before, before and after voting, we disinfected all polling stations and counting centers, carried out body temperature check, hand disinfection, distancing of 1 meter, and social distancing in polling stations as well. So we have come up with many safety measures for the election. And the government has promoted the prevention measures through promotional videos and leaflets with National Election Commission. And our citizens trusted our measures, so that's why we achieved good results.
Second question, what the indicator and how to evaluate? Is there no new cluster of COVID-19 because of the election? Considering that the period of the COVID-19 virus incubation is usually 2 weeks, we have strengthened the monitorings of the spread of the COVID-19 for 2 weeks from the election day with the disease management headquarters and the local government, especially during the date of the elections, voters, especially who are under the quarantine, we have done any kind of the epidemiological investigations, and just in case we prepared everything. And also, 2 weeks after the election day, we have conducted epidemiological investigation and found that there are no cases of the infections related with the elections. In other words, if you put on mask and practice social distance, definitely you can prevent infections of the COVID-19.
세 번째 질문입니다. Third question. In case there are new cases because of the election, what kind of responsibility will be taken by the government? As I explained before, there was no single case related to the election was reported. In Korea, confirmed patients could get assistance for admission fees from the government, and the government supports diagnostic test fees utilizing National Healthcare Insurance Service. And the fourth question, who is in task and who is in charge to make sure all implemented based on the health protocol? National Election Commission, KCDC, local governments, and Ministry of Interior and Safety had discussions to come up with prevention and control measures as well as health protocols. The fifth question, how many people have been registered in the 21st national election? The total number of voters for the general election was 43,994,247, and 66.2% or 29,126,396 cast their votes.
Sixth question, are there any restrictions on the number of the voters when they are in a polling station? Well, there were no restrictions on the number of the people entering the polling station. However, since there was a waiting line, we made sure that there is a 1 meter distance between the people, and we managed that strictly. Therefore, people inside or near the vicinity of the polling station, we maintained the person number.
Seventh question, what is the procedure of voting in hospital? As I mentioned before, confirmed patients could cast their votes in hospitals by mail. First, we requested cooperation from the hospital, so we made sure that ballot papers were delivered to confirm the patients. So patients needed to put on a mask and wear disposable gloves before voting. After voting, the patients gave the envelope and ballot to the hospital, and the hospital disinfected the envelopes received from the patients and put them into the mailbox.
투표 종사원에게 별도의 휴식 시간을 부여했는지,
Were there any
마스크를 쓰고 있었는데 for 어려움은 없었는지, 또한
polling station members and polling station staff members and any problems with the election of identity as a result of wearing mask and how many members does the polling station have worked. There was no break or break time for our voting staff members. But depending on the situation in a polling station, voting station manager were able to give rest to the staff members. And after voting, public officers were granted for a special leave after voting so as to they can get some rest. And in case where a voter is wearing a mask, then the officer asked the voter to pull down the mask for identification.
그 본인 확인하는 투표 종사원들은 이제
페이스
마스크를 착용하도록 해서
also staff members of a polling station wear a face mask to prevent possible infection.
그리고 투표소별 직원 현황 같은 경우에는
and when it comes to the number of staff members of a polling station on average about 11 polling station members were assigned.
기존의 인력에 기존의 그전에 코로나19 사태가 아닌 일반 선거 때에 비해서
So compared to the general election we added two more staff members to prevent possible infection. And next question.
투표소의 평균 크기는 어떻게 되었으며
Next question. What is the average size of the polling station in rural area or the urban area? How many voters can be assigned to the polling station? How long does it take to cast a vote? The size of the polling station differs depending on the number of the voters applicable to each polling station, so average size is insignificant. However, in terms of the arithmetic figures, there were a total of the 14,330 voting stations. The smallest one was 21.3 cubic meter. The largest one was 12,110 cubic meter, which means that if we come up with the average size, it's about 182.6 square meter. We also try to adjust around 5,000 voters per polling station, but there are some modifications depending on the various circumstances. And amid COVID-19, we have conducted national elections. So in case of the average time per person, it took about 1 minute per voters.
다음 질문입니다.
Next question.
투표 방역을 위해 얼마나 많은
How much are the expenses for sanitary materials and what kind of sanitary materials have you bought for our voters? For the 21st general election, 226 billion, 0.7 billion, one of budget was allocated, but about additional 20 billion won was added to prevent the further spread of the virus. And we bought masks, hand sanitizers, and contactless temperature checker, and disinfect tissues, and medical gloves, and PPEs, and facial masks, and plastic gloves. Next question. And how has you accepted candidates registration? So when it comes to registration of candidates for the 21st general election, we carried out two ways. First is accepting applications on site, and second is by mail. So to prevent further infection or contagion, candidates and on-site, and there was a blockage between site manager and candidates who tried to register themselves for the election, and also we asked them to use hand sanitizers. And next is, how has campaign movement going on, and in what format were the election campaigns of candidates and political party held? What was the maximum amount of people allowed for the meetings with the candidates and political parties? And it was totally different from what we had done before because of the COVID-19. We tried to minimize any possible contacts, so we focused on campaign movement, online campaign movement and promotion.
만남이 허용되는 최대 인원을
And there was no rules regarding the number of people who can meet the candidates or have meetings. So we made sure to minimize the possible contact between voters and candidates. So following the rules, campaign movement had been carried out. And the next question. And I'd like to know. The voting process organized for people residing outside of Korea. So overseas absentees or expatriates needed to register themselves for voting, for overseas voting. So overseas voting polling stations were installed in diplomatic missions. However, depending on the situation of other countries, we decided to carry out other way of elections. So in 62 other countries, we carried out overseas voting. And next is,
how did you verify the ID of the voters at the polling station? The voting station staff confirms the identity of the voters through the voter's ID. As I mentioned before, the voting station staff member did not speak at all to the voters, but asked the voter to show their face briefly, and then whether the person is a real person on the ID card by looking at the face.
야외에서 투표 절차가 어떻게 진행되었습니까?
How has the outdoor voting proceeded?
이번 선거에서 발열이라든가 또는
Those who had fever or respiratory symptoms
증상이 의심되는
cast their vote
경우에는 별도로
at temporary polling booth installed outdoor.
관련된 절차와
So let me talk about the procedure.
우선
First
동일하게 이 선거인
It's
동안
the same. A voter needs to disinfect hands and wear disposable gloves. And then, polling station staff member checked ID of the voter. And then the voter can enter into the polling station and get ballot papers.
선거인에게 임시기표소 봉투와 함께 전달을 하였습니다.
And envelopes as well.
그리고 그 선거인은 임시기표소에
And then the voter enters into a polling booth, temporary polling booth.
투표를 하게 되고
And with an observer.
투표가 끝나게 되면
And after the voter finishes the voting,
투표대와 기표 용구 등을
Then the polling booth and polling tools
임시기표소 투표를
were disinfected for other people so that other people can vote.
What legal regulations did you introduce in the voting process?
Well, frankly speaking,
the national election was scheduled right after the outbreak of the COVID-19, so there were no laws or legal regulations established. However, as I mentioned, we made sure that all voters are required to wear a mask, and when they arrive at the polling station, we made sure that they wear facial mask and keep the social distance, we ask them to cooperate.
다음 질문입니다. 선거 참여자들에게 투표
Next.
과정에서 어떤 행동 강령을 마련하였습니까?
What kind of, what code of conduct was introduced to votes, to voters during the period?
행동 수칙을 마련하여서
And we have carried out call to actions for all citizens, and we also established call to actions for the general elections.
어린 자녀 등은 가급적 투표소에 동반하지
First,
않기
First, do not bring your young children to the polling station and before going to the polling station wash your hands and wear a mask and at the entrance of a polling station you need to disinfect your hands and wear disposable gloves and you must keep a distance of at least 1 meter between other voters and refrain from having unnecessary conversations or chats and pulling down or taking off your mask in a polling station when officials ask to check your identification. This is a code of conduct.
Next question, did you extend the voting time for the voters on the election day?
선거 시간 투표 시간을 연장하기 위해서는
In order to extend the voting time, we actually need to revise the law in Korea.
법 개정이 이루어지지 않았기
But
때문에 별도의
we didn't revise the law, and there was no
이제,
extensions of the voting time. However, in case of other countries,
법 개정이라든가 다른 if 절차를 마련을 통해서
I believe in order to extend the voting time, you need to revise the law or directives, and
I believe that it could create
additional effect of distributing the number of the voters coming into the voting station.
Next, what were the special procedures for the population under self-isolation, and have all of them casted their votes? Not all people who are in self-isolation were able to cast their votes. So those who had no symptoms on the election day and those who showed their intention for voting were allowed for general election voting.
다음 질문입니다. 투표를 Next 위한 question. 자가격리자 이동 대책은 무엇이었습니까?
What were the distance between the voting committees, observers and voters? Since they were not allowed to go outside because of the possible infection, and to guarantee political rights, we allowed them to go outside. But in case some confirmed patients had to go out, we asked them to walk on foot or move using their vehicles. And the whole history of travel of confirmed patients were checked by our officer through our self-isolation application.
And next question.
What was the voting process for the people under quarantine? In case of the people under quarantine, we try to make sure that we need to minimize any contact with the general public, so the space and the time were separated completely. First of all, in case of the people under quarantine, they need to arrive at the polling station before 6 p.m. and they arrive at the waiting area. We distribute the number of tickets depending on the number of tickets right after the general public casted vote and depart the polling stations. They go to the special polling station and cast vote. And just like the general public, right after they cast vote, the staff members go inside the polling stations and we sanitize and disinfect the polling equipment and also the booth as well. And also the protective gears were worn by the staff members at the voting process.
다음 질문입니다.
The next question, how far National Election Commission observers voters apart from one another at a polling station? At a polling station, all people needed to keep at least 1 meter distance between voters, and also observers had to keep 1 meter of distance between other voters and observers. And also, polling station staff members needed to keep 1.5 meters of distance.
다음 질문입니다.
Next question, how many voters were allowed at the polling stations on the election day? As I have mentioned before, we tried to adjust the number of the voters per polling station to maximum 5,000, but depending on the environment and circumstances, there were differences. Especially, we didn't put any restrictions on the number of the voters entering the polling station. However, we made sure that 1 meter of the distance must be kept between the people, and if there are a lot of people concentrated at a certain time, we need to distribute the people, but it didn't happen actually.
And the next question, what was the counting procedure? How the counting has proceeded? First, when it comes to securing counting centers, we secured large facilities as counting centers, and we made sure all ventilation functions work well. And just like the polling station, we checked people's temperature when they enter into a counting center, and if people has a fever, then they were not allowed to enter into the counting center. And inside the counting center, all people needed to wear gloves and wear a mask.
This is the last question. In case of the closure of a polling station, how did you inform to voters about the locations of the alternate polling station? In preparing the national election, there were not a case of the closures of the polling station at all, but we had an alternative plans and plan B just in case the polling station is closed down. In case it's closed down, they will notify through the web page, and also we will put a notice board on the regional polling stations, and we plan to make sure that a polling staff member stay there and give notice to the people who come and cast a vote. And also in each municipals and district, they have prepared a special vehicle so that if the voters come to cast a vote, but if the polling station is closed, they can ride in a special vehicle and go to the alternate polling station.
네, 이 외에 추가적으로 주신
There are some other questions raised during the webinar, but since the answers are overlapping, we'll skip them. We sincerely hope that Korea's experience will help other countries that plan to hold elections in the future successfully and safely. Once again, we'd like to express our sincere gratitude to all the participants who were interested in and participate in the webinar. This concludes the special webinar. Thank you.